Hello there, I'm back with another exciting update of my Tesla board build. Probably not that exciting, but for some of you. Anyway, how did I get there? Let's recap. I started out with a simple goal to experiment with Toyota Prius gearbox and inverter and get it to work as an electric drivetrain using open inverter board. And let me tell you, it was a fun journey. I had to tinker and experiment with the Prius gearbox and inverter to get everything working smoothly. But then things took a thrilling turn when I came across a cheap Tesla motor on eBay. I could not resist the opportunity to take things up a notch, so I decided to take the plunge and bought the Tesla motor. And again, my plan was to replace the Tesla controller with the Tesla small drive unit variant of the open inverter board. At first, everything seems to be going well, but then disaster struck. I damaged the current sensors while trying to unsolder them. And just when I thought things couldn't get any worse, the open inverter board wouldn't power up. I quickly discovered that some components placement was wrong. But you know what they say, when the going gets tough, the tough gets going. With a little help and advice from fellow EV conversion enthusiast, I finally got my hands on the right sensor model. Now I'm taking extra precautions to ensure that everything is working properly and testing open inverter board on the bench first before fitting into the inverter. After last week's shenanigans, I decided to program open Tesla inverter board before I start soldering any more components. This would allow me in a way to check if STM32 processor is working properly. As usual, I use ST-Link programmer to do the programming bit. As Tesla being a synchronous motor, it will require to use the sine firmware rather than field-oriented control firmware I used for the Prius motor. First, I need to connect ST-Link programmer and load the bootloader. Program and verify. After this, I could program the sine firmware and program and verify again. If programming is successful, first I should get the message in ST-Link utility and then LED should start flashing on the open inverter board. Yes, that looks good. No surprises this time for me. Once I programmed the board and I could see that it was working, I could finish off by adding missing components. Soldering FETs is a bit more challenging. As they have rather large heatsinks, I had to cover the pad and FET backside with the flux and heat the pad for much longer to ensure that solder properly had flown into the pad. I continue my work with the board and I'm now doing the Wi-Fi module. So, oh! That was brilliant, wasn't it? I continue my work with the board and now I moved on to soldering in the Wi-Fi module designed to use Olimex little module that plugs into the connector. But I don't really like Olimex because it's not easy to program them. You have to plug in additional interface here and it's a bit more elaborate. So I've decided to go to VMOS D1 Mini. Just a drop of instant glue and our little Wi-Fi module was securely attached to the board. Connectors, do I really need them? I don't know. Maybe I'm just procrastinating at this stage. But I have decided to solder them. As I justified it for myself, it will be easier to do testing with them. Perhaps I'm just stalling to delay the testing, who knows. The minor complication was that I needed to steal some parts from the Tesla board. I hope Elon doesn't mind. And that brought memory of those damaged sensors. But this time I took extra care, and the connector shroud and locking mechanisms were removed successfully. To complete my mission, I needed to fit a shroud onto newly soldered connector and fit the locking mechanism. Now I have external connector on the board. I need a receptacle part so I can expose some connections for testing. This means that I have to assemble Molex connector and crimp some wires. Well, let's get crimping. I cut some wires to size so I can have them as my testing harness. I can always extend them later if I need to. I'm not much of an expert on crimping and I only had to do it once before when I was making a connector for the Toyota Prius inverter. but I hope that my crimping tool will be suitable for this job as well. The approach I take is to position the pin in the tool first and insert the wire once the pin is locked in the tool. What is critical is to choose the right size for the pin. I'm using 80 to 20 AVG wire pins, so I selected the middle crimping position, which is closer to 0.8 mm square. Once the wire is inserted to the right depth, I just squeeze the trigger. Sorry, I mean the crimping tool. And the job is done. Now all that is left to do is to insert the pin inside the connector and get locking mechanism in place once all the pins have been done. Excellent, guys, our board is progressing nicely and it's almost ready for testing. I already have a connector and testing harness built up, so it plugs in from the back side of the Tesla board, pretty much how it goes into the inverter. And all I need to do is I will need to finish off and solder in the start ignition switch and start inverter switch. Let's crack on with that. Okay, the plan is I will connect the ignition switch coming in from this side, so the power will be applied here, and I want to transfer this power to another two or three connectors here, and these two would be our ground. First, we connect pin number 13, which is power, so it should be distributed through all of those 1, 2, 3, and 4. So this is pin number 9, and that goes to start button. Turn here, it will go into position 2 in this case. And of course the last thing we need to wire up is to wire up the ground. Now I want to do a simple startup test just to start an inverter, power on, ignition on, press start button and see if the web interface shows us that the inverter is started. Okay, first I need to plug in the connector here. Oops. So we rearranged our power. Okay, now the crunch time. Power supply is on and apply the power. And the switch on. And it's working. As for the rest of this test, I had to reconnect to the ESP module to make sure that I have a connection to my VMOS D1 mini, and then start inverter in the manual mode and inverter started. Excellent, it's working. And then if I stop the inverter, inverter halted. Brilliant, my web interface is working and my inverter is starting. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Please like if you enjoyed this video, this will help to support the channel. Please subscribe if you want to see more. Next video will follow up next week, where I'll be doing further testing of the inverter on the bench. And I will see you next time.